So here we were, miles up the Tietê River, looking for what we did not know.
Max. You listening? Max! So like I was saying, I think they're a group called the Crachapret.
Why'd you tell me they were called the CS?
They are. I mean, Fabiana. She was kidnapped by the CS. The guys that crashed that little party at the stadium, they were a group of paramilitaries.
You'll have to forgive me for not being able to follow all this.
You're not supposed to follow it. The government can't even follow it. It ensures that no one's ever guilty.
So why'd they do it? Bust us at the stadium.
Somebody told them we were gonna be there with a whole lot of money. Anyway, the money's gone. Just hope we can get the girl back.
Yeah, me too. Wonder where the hell she is.
You know there's a harbor about a half a mile up? She's gotta be there. This is a known Comando Sombra area.
You know, if I've been doing my job properly, we wouldn't be out here in the middle of nowhere looking for some broad who got pinched on my watch.
That's what we tell ourselves, huh? It's all our fault.
No, I'm serious. By the time they grabbed the girls, I was half cut. I ain't slipping, man. I'm slipped. I'm a bad joke.
Max, we work private security. We're all ex-soldiers, ex-special forces, ex-cops, ex-good guys. We all have our reasons why we became ex. Maybe now we can put things right, okay?
So that was it, was it? Say the magic word and be absolved of your sins. If only shit were that simple, I'd have done it years ago. Me, I've been stuck in the past so long, I'd forgotten what year it was.
Max, quit your daydreaming. This is it. It's over there. I'm gonna cut the engine. Light in.
Don't go anywhere.
Here I was, some hopped-up gringo a long way from home, making trouble the only way I knew. As the weather worsened, I caught a glimpse of the rusted shells of previous lives that had been lived out here in this swampy shithole, and I wondered if I would end up the same way, or what would happen to that girl I was supposed to protect. I had no idea what lay ahead, and as much as part of me would rather be anywhere else, I knew this was where I had to be. I felt responsible. I just had to fix the situation, right here. I couldn't understand them, but I didn't have to. Cheap hoods are the same from here to Timbuktu. The slab of meat on the boat was clearly the boss. Serrano, they called him. And it seemed that our suspicions were correct. Fabiana was here, somewhere further ahead. I had to find her quickly and quietly if possible. Last thing I wanted was a party with these clowns. So far, I'd managed to keep a low profile, a bit out of character for a guy who's only comfortable with a bottle of whiskey or a gun in his hand. I kept moving toward the signs of life, rubbing them out as I went along. had seen enough to know that Fabiana was at least alive, if not exactly well. Her captors didn't look like they were quite the kind and gentle type. I had to find that room quickly.
Vai se fuder, cara!
Vai tomar no meio do cu!
Eu vou te meter bala, hein!
Vai se fuder, porra!
Oi! Dani! Você tá aí? Você tem um cigarro?
Agora!
I didn't want to think about what would be happening on that video feed now. Just my own imminent cameo. I had to keep moving. I hoped that I'd find Fabiana sooner than later, if at all. Chair that she had been held in. I had just missed them.
A dor. Com a idade vem a dor. É dor de cabeça.
Here we go again. She was on the move. If they'd finally decided to kill her, I wasn't doing anything to persuade them otherwise. There she was, right in front of me. The drunk fool in me wanted to make a play. But I had just about enough sense to know that I'd end up with another dead girl in my arms if I did.
O irmão já falou, velho, ele quer a inteira.
Aí, isso é jogar dinheiro no bicho, hein?
Caralho, cara, tá virando uma cilada essa porra, mano.
Cocaine factory, but I'd stick to the depressants. I open the door to the next circle of this low-rent hell.
cabeça dele! Demorou!
Você tá morto, Lua! Morto!
At least I wasn't following the trail of her fingers. Malaria tablets might have been more useful out there. I had to keep on going across the docks. There they were. I had the feeling I'd been running one step behind ever since I got to this country. And maybe a few years before that as well.
They took her in a boat. That way. Straight ahead.
Okay, don't worry. Hang on.
Boy, did I need to hang on. The whole operation was slipping out of our grip. I was an overconfident chump going into the jungle alone.
Shit, more company!
Thank you.
idea. Hold on.
This shit's gonna come down to more than willpower.
Who's in?
Slipped through my fingers for a second time. Another habit I didn't want or need.
It was close. We almost had her. Damn!
I don't think we ever had much of a chance. No one told us they had an entire goddamn army.
I don't think anybody knew. Crazy shit.
Yeah. It's all crazy, pal. Non-stop insanity. Thought I left all this shit behind. Easy gig, you said. What a fool I was to get involved in this madness.
Thank you.
Wake up, Max. Come on. Get up, you big bastard. Come on.
I'm up.
Yeah? You don't look up.
Just give me a second, will you? I'm really not feeling too good.
Hey, Max, what is it with you in interior design? Huh? You really know how to give a place a great lived-in feel, huh? This is beautiful.
Fuck off with the fucking wisecracks. Really, I'm not in the mood.
Okay, sorry, bro. The boss wants to see us, so let's go, come on. Take your time, man. Fucking unbelievable. Jesus.
I heard that.
Oh, give me a second. I'm not feeling so good.
Bom dia.
Ela está aí?
O que o senhor acha? Claro que sim. E o senhor bem pontual,
tudo bem.
Não?
Ah.
You fucking pair of clowns!
I'm sorry, sir. We risked our lives several times over trying to save...
I know. I just wish I knew what was happening and why.
Yes. Who has it in for our family?
I mean, just because we are rich and happy. Is that a good reason to hate us? I do a lot of good in this town. A lot.
This is hell for me. As I told you yesterday, when I get Fabiana back, I think I will move us to Miami or Geneva. It feels like nothing good can come from living in São Paulo right now.
I hope you're not giving up on our city, Senor Branco. Listen, we will catch the man. You have my word on that.
Listen to Mr. Becker, brother. Yes, these are tough times, but we have been through it before. Like when father died.
Father had a heart attack visiting a brothel. Yeah, it was humiliating, embarrassing for sure. But now this is different. This is the end for me.
Well, she's not dead. Maybe we'll be lucky and get her back safe soon.
I can almost guarantee it, if you do as I ask.
Maybe.
Be strong, brother. For your wife. I know this has been tough on you. But things will get better. For all of us. Hmm?
Marcelo, pasos in my helicopter. This way.
Sure.
Mr. Becker?
Senor?
Let us give you a ride.
Bom. Até logo, Senor Branco. And may I say, you would be best served se contratar profissionais e não esses amadores pés de chinelo.
Goodbye, Mr. Becker.
Até logo, Senor Branco.
I had so many plans, Max.
Didn't we all?
I was born into great fortune. Sometimes it feels like I have done nothing apart from being a rich man in a poor country. The men I talk to, they only see money. Now my wife. I am not naive. She does not love me for my body.
Well, despite your good fortune, you're still a decent man.
Am I? I don't know. I try to be. But maybe I'm just another rich fool, just like the rest of my friends.
Com licença. Tem uma ligação para o senhor, um policial chamado Senhor da Silva.
Ah, diga que eu ligo mais tarde.
Sim.
Another bent cop wanting a pension contribution. Do you think a pile of shit feels popular because it's surrounded by flies? Look at me. I'm a mess.
O que está acontecendo? Meu Deus! Sim, pode entrar!
Senhor, temos problema. O sistema de segurança foi desativado.
I can see that! We got men entering the building, and the office won't lock down.
Posso?
Claro que pode.
It's not working. There's a way to reboot the system. If I can get to the server room, I should be able to get everything back online.
Strange. You pay a couple million dollars and you expect to push a button to be able to make all your problems go away. All I got was some useless junk and a bit of false confidence. I'm done, Max.
Sir, let us handle this. You stay in your office, lock yourself in. Do not answer the door unless you know it's me. Let's go.
I should be able to override the system if I could just get to the server room.
What's going on?
Nothing to worry about. Everything's fine. Get down behind the desk now, both of you.
Max? Max!
Yeah, it's safe. Come on.
We need to get you to the server room. Let's go.
Por que não posso ficar aqui com você debaixo da mesa?
Let's go. Come on.
Okay. I'm coming. Come on.
The real security guards had been run off, paid off, or bumped off. That left us. It wasn't a fantastically comforting thought.
Please! Come on!
This code should get us into the boardroom. Okay.
Glad to see the security system is keeping the right people out.
Ah! Oh, shit!
What the hell?
Are we dead?
No such luck. We gotta go.
It's through here. It's through here. Get that thing away from me.
These clowns were the same guns for hire who jumped our exchange at the stadium. Crotch a Prado, the black badge, right-wing paramilitary chumps protecting whoever paid the most. I guess that made them more like me than I cared to admit. Were they just looking for another payday, or did their business with the Broncos run deeper?
Eu vou por aqui, você vai por aqui.
Get that server back online.
Can we just spend a few more minutes? Make sure they're all gone?
Come on, don't worry. I got your back.
Poor kid was scared shitless. But I thought we'd seen the worst of it.
Okay. The server room is just down here.
You're doing good. Come on.
Hey? I didn't think I'd have a day like this when I wake up in the mornings.
Wish I could say the same thing. Fact was, I'd gotten used to protecting Bronco in the big bad world. We hadn't anticipated a siege situation here, hadn't prepared for it. I couldn't tell the kid that. Something told me these guys didn't have security clearance. Fix this or what?
In a few minutes, eh? I should be able to reboot the system, get all the components back online.
What about Bronco's office? That's all I care about.
You should be able to lock us down, eh? If this works.
Whatever you're doing, do it quick. I'm gonna make a sweep of the building and then get back to Rodrigo's.
The security system was back online. Things might be a little tougher for our fan club from here on in. Seemed like breaching the perimeter had been no more difficult than strolling through the front gates. But hey, Who needs a Trojan horse when the alarm is down and your standing army is a dame, a dork, and a drunk? Bronco's office overlooked the atrium. I could check in and make sure he hadn't checked out.
Max! Your guy's working on the security system now, sir.
It just came on.
Okay, good. Then lock yourself down. Stay put. Let us take care of these guys down here. Once they realize they can't get to you, they should back off.
Max, try not to completely destroy the place.
Let's just concentrate on staying alive. Sir!
There it went. He was tucked up safe. Now I needed to make it to the lobby to complete my sweep of the building, for what that was worth. They could invoice me. Poor girl was dead. Shot through the head by some hero fighting the rich one lonely secretary at a time. We'd seen the worst of it. The elevator would take me back up to Rodrigo's office where we could wait the rest of it out. I didn't know what the hell I was gonna find up there, but I sensed it wasn't gonna be a stripper bursting out of a cake.
Senor Branco! Senor Branco! I can't get through to him. Ever since the security door is triggered, he hasn't made a sound.
Rodrigo, it's Max. Open up! Can you hear me?
Eu já tentei.
Senor Branco, open up! I'm gonna try to get in there from the roof. You find the security guard and get the hell out of here.
Yes.
I knew there was another way in upstairs for the helipad, the little luxury runaround that kept the rich looking down on the poor literally as well as metaphorically.
Rodrigo! Rodrigo! Rodrigo!
He was dead. Clean, one shot, a professional job. I began to look for clues.
Uh,
get playback on one of the cameras and it looked like the disc was missing. Someone in this building was trying to keep things low-key. But then why had everyone else come driving through the goddamn wall? Fabiana. Even if the man who employed me was dead, his wife was still out there. Maybe she could be saved. Maybe some good would... Picking the photo from the broken fragments, something caught my eye.
Figures.
Only blind luck it meant the blast wasn't fatal. If I'd been out for any longer, the smoke would have gotten me. I was gonna get crushed to death. Look at me. I've been contracted to protect two people. One was being held in some hole. The other was sitting at his desk with a bullet in his head. And the company that had its logo on my paycheck was melting on top of my head. If I survived this, it'd be a victory for gross incompetence. The kid hadn't made it. Fuck. I had to make this corpse-looting coward pay. Getting his gun was more than just expediency. Was falling apart quite literally. Despite his manners, I'd done him a favor. This didn't look like a room where Rodrigo closed multi-million dollar deals. It looked like a fiery hellhole. Filing cabinet. Oh. So much for a lazy Sunday afternoon. My next trick would be a high wire act with a fiery pit for a safety net. It was nice that no one was shooting at me for a change, but I'd take shot in the head over a slow roast on a spit any day of the goddamn week. Someone up ahead was hurt pretty bad. If he didn't die before I got to him, I might get some answers.
Hey! Why? Why Rodrigo Branco? Why did you come to kill Rodrigo Branco?
Came to kill you! Because of what you did to us! You killed so many of us!
What reason did this poor bastard have to lie? He would be dead from shock or loss of blood in half an hour, even if I didn't leave him there to burn.
Where's Fabiana?
What?
Fabiana Branco, where is she?
La Comando Sombra got her. Up the hill.
Then it was up the hill for me, I guess, where the gang held sway. I had to try to figure out who was using these angry paramilitary clowns as some kind of front to kill Rodrigo.